Hey, what is up, guys? George here, and welcome for the weekly Forex analysis. In this video, I'm going to be analyzing US dollar, Japanese yen, followed by US dollar against Canada. This is for the following week, 13th to 17th of July, for the potential swing trading. If I see any potential trades, I will be mentioning any entries, exits, as well as the stop losses. Okay, so without further ado, jump into and analyzing the charts. Okay, we are starting with the US dollar Japanese yen from the monthly time frame first. Don't forget, guys, to smash the like on this video, as well as if you're new to this channel, smash that subscribe. I do upload regular content on YouTube. So, okay, let's start with the US Japanese yen monthly time frame. What we have in here, we have this nice trend line in place since pretty much about 2016, which is still in play. We can see in here that the price is attempted several times to break it. Look at this spikes up here. Like, the price attempted several times to break this trend line. However, each time it has failed. Last couple of months, we can see in here is the price looks very ugly. Look at this indecision candles in here, all the way up to its good since pretty much January. It's been putting these indecision candles, and for this month, we're seeing some kind of a reaction, but obviously, we are still quite far away from this month to end, so it can change the course. Now we are seeing that the price is making its way down. However, it's still not clear. We're still sitting in this wedge pattern, and also we have this trend line in here. Let's go to the weekly time frame. Let's see what we got on a weekly time frame. Okay, on a weekly time frame, we have cleared this lower and upper trend line in here, which is sort of a wedge pattern, and the price is trying to squeeze in between this upper and lower trend line. Ignore this one, it doesn't really make much of a sense on the weekly time frame. Just looking in terms of the monthly time frame, so ignore this trend line in here. So we're going to concentrate this to, we can see the price is squeezing in between its trend lines, and could mean that the price go up and down, until eventually it will break this either upper trend line or the lower one. So let's go to daily time frame. What we have on the daily time frame. So on the daily time frame, the price tested, came down for another test. So it tested in here, come down for another test to test this trend line. And it's pretty much sitting on this trend line since it was a Friday, closed the market. So we're going to see what's going to happen on the following week. I can't really say anything at the moment in terms of the levels getting in, out, and in terms of the target, because the price is very unpredictable. And I did mention on my last weekly analysis that and many other videos that in this summer season, or the vacation or festive season, whatever they call it, I call it summer season, it's very normal to experience this low volatility. I know a lot of you newer traders, you find it this very stressful and very annoying, because we don't get much trades when there's low volatility. We need the volatility to get the trades, and this summer season can last, this low volatility season can last a good 3 months, if not more. Okay, next we got US dollar against Canada from the monthly time frame first. Okay, we can see that since the price has tested this, pretty much came out and made this nice high up here, it's been going down. We have also this nice week, and if we look at the last couple of months, the price has been going down. So this is the first thing we need to notice. We have this very steep downwards trend line, and it does looking that maybe the price will continue to fall. However, it doesn't looking as strong for now that the for me to make me think that, okay, the price gonna fall and continue to fall. Let's go to the weekly time frame. We're gonna get the clearer and clearer pictures in terms of here. Okay, so we can see we had this nice 2 weeks down, sort of down momentum, followed by this last couple of weeks, we had this what looks like a retracement. So the price came all the way up, took out these highs, these weekly highs as well. It tested this weekly resistance level up here. If you can see it, it's about same level at this time. So it tested that, had a reaction last week, nice down bar, and for this week, it's put this sort of a spinning top candle. know. So it does not really tell us much. So this is, again, it is on the indecision. It doesn't really, price doesn't really show where is it going. If you can look at, this is a daily time frame. If you look at this this area in here, it is going up and down. It is chopping around. So price came up and almost tested the just air kiss this trend line. And on this one, for this for the Friday, the price came and tested this trend line. So in the following week, hopefully we're gonna see some movements in the price, that we're gonna either the price gonna break and go higher, or it's gonna start breaking down. And if the price gonna start breaking down or break up, then we're gonna have a bit of a clearer picture of what we're gonna do. For now, it's not very clear what the price is doing. So this is a great for the practicing your patience. I know it can be very frustrating because you don't get trades, but we can't just force our will onto the market, because usually and most of the times it does not end up in our favor. So this is a patience game, and I will be mentioning if I see any potential trades on my Discord channel. So not to worry, link is in the description. If you want to join, feel free. And this Discord channel is completely free. I do share my trades, as well as you can interact with me also with the other members of our Discord channel. Thank you guys for watching. Before you click off, make sure to smash the like on this video, as well as if you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button. Have a great weekend, and I will see you guys in my next video.